Agriculture, in which use is made only of naturally available inputs, is called natural agriculture. Since these inputs are available without any cost, their efficient use increases the farmer's profits. In this discourse, I shall talk on natural ways of controlling insect pests, diseases, and damage by herbivores. Plants can't run away from their attackers. Therefore, they evolve many mechanisms to protect themselves. Among the mechanical means of self-protection, one can cite thorns, hard spines, as well as deposition of silica into the cell wall. In Australia, the merino sheep wear out their teeth by foraging on the silica-rich natural grasses. Such sheep have to be slaughtered because they can no longer feed themselves. However, the teeth of the breeding rams, kept in pens and eating feed pellets, remain intact. The husk of rice contains almost 40% silica. It protects the grain from insects that normally feed on stored grain. The same characteristic is also shown by a species of wheat called Triticum dicoccum. It is grown in the southern part of Maharashtra and northern parts of Karnataka. Some plants contain gums, resins, and rubber. These substances are originally liquid, but they solidify later into a sticky gel. This gel gags the insects feeding on the plants. But apart from these physical means, plants also use various chemicals to protect themselves from predators. There exist in nature almost 100,000 species of insects which feed on plants. The number of pathogens is even greater, and yet one finds only a few species of insects and fungal pathogens infesting a single plant species. Another fact about the insect pests and diseases is that those infecting one plant species are generally not found on a different plant species unless the two plant species are closely related. The fact that the silkworms feed only on mulberry leaves and not on the leaves of any other plant is an example of this phenomenon. This phenomenon can be explained by the fact that the protective chemicals of a plant species are unique to that species. Therefore, the insects and diseases that evolve the capability of overcoming the defenses of a particular plant species cannot infest other plant species having other protective chemicals. Therefore, it is theoretically possible to kill the insects infesting one plant species by exposing them to the protective chemicals of another plant species. The use of tobacco decoction and neem seed extract as insecticides is based on the same principle. Tobacco decoction would be ineffective on insects feeding on a tobacco plant, and neem seed extract would have no effect on the insect pests on the neem plant. All plants possess protective substances known as phenolic compounds. These compounds combine with proteins to form insoluble complexes. This reaction interferes with the protein digestion. That is also the reason why the Ayurvedic drugs cannot be injected, because such an injection would coagulate the blood plasma of the patient. In addition, the phenolic compounds impart bitterness and astringency to the plant. The brown, black, or red color of the seed coat of many plants is also due to the presence of phenolic compounds. Removal of the seed coat improves their digestibility. Due to these characteristics, the phenolics protect plants from insects. Some of them also inhibit the germination of fungal spores. While domesticating wild plants to serve as food, humans selected plants having a pleasant taste. As a result, the concentration of the phenolic compounds is generally lower in cultivated plants than in their wild relatives. The extracts of uncultivated plant species are therefore generally more effective as pesticides than the extracts of cultivated plants. Now that we know that plants have their own insecticides and that they can also be used against the insect pests of other plant species, we can look at our local uncultivated plants as a source of insecticides. Scientists have already identified candidate plants for this purpose. But before allowing farmers to use their extracts as agricultural pesticides, one must make sure that they are safe for humans, fish, poultry, cattle, honeybees, wasps, etc. Many Ayurvedic drugs also show pesticidal properties, but they should not be used as agricultural pesticides because their use as medicines itself indicates that they may affect the human physiology. The insects use volatile substances called pheromones to communicate with other members of their own species. Pheromones that are used by female insects to attract males are called sex pheromones. Use is made of sex pheromones in insect traps which attract and kill the males of that particular insect pest. There are also predatory insects like wasps which kill insect pests, but because they need special rearing and handling techniques, it may not be possible for every farmer to use them. Fungal pathogens are controlled by plants by synthesizing antifungal substances after a pathogen has entered the plant cell. In most cases, the chitin in the fungal cell wall elicits the synthesis of an enzyme called chitinase, which kills the fungus by destroying its cell wall. Chitin is also present in prawn shells. It is available as a waste product with enterprises that export prawns. If applied to a field, prawn shell powder often renders the crop resistant to many fungal diseases. It is relatively easy to breed disease-resistant crop varieties. Using traditional plant breeding techniques, breeders could therefore develop varieties of rust-resistant wheat, downy mildew-resistant bajra, and sorghum that resists grain mold when the panicles become wet due to rain. Once a disease-resistant variety becomes available, the farmers need not worry about protecting the crop from that particular disease. On the other hand, breeding for insect resistance is relatively difficult. Farmers are still waiting for plants resistant to insects such as aphids, white grub, white fly, locusts, and many others. However, resistance to caterpillars presents a success story. Plants have been rendered resistant to caterpillars by introducing into their genome the gene for producing a bacterial insecticide called Bt toxin. Most of the varieties with Bt gene are, however, patented. Herbivorous mammals like wild elephants, deer, bisons, monkeys, etc. are a menace to crops grown in farms near wildlife sanctuaries. Farmers in such localities should grow crops which are unpalatable to foraging animals. An example is lemongrass and citronella. Foraging animals leave them alone because they contain pungent essential oils in their leaves. These two crops are quite remunerative. Their oil is no longer looked upon just as a source of perfumes. There is a huge international demand for them as a source of certain chemicals required by the chemical industry.